I'll sing you a poem of a silly young king who played with the world at the end of a string, but he only loved one single thing, and that was just a peanut butter sandwich. His scepter and his royal gowns, his regal throne and golden crowns were all brown and sticky from the mounds and drippings from each peanut butter sandwich. His subjects all were silly fools, for he had passed a royal rule that all that they could learn in school was how to make a peanut butter sandwich. He would not eat his sovereign steak. No, mm-mm. He scorned his soup. Take it away, take it away. And his kingly cake. And told his courtly cook to bake an extra sticky peanut butter sandwich. Mm. And then, one day, he took a bite. And started chewing with delight. But he found that his mouth was stuck quite tight from that last bite of peanut butter sandwich. His brother pulled, his sister pried, the wizard pushed, his mother cried, my boy's committed suicide from eating that last peanut butter sandwich. The dentist came, and the royal doc, the royal plumber, banged, and knocked, but still those jaws stayed tightly locked. Oh, damn that sticky peanut butter sandwich. The carpenter, he tried with pliers. The telephone man tried with wires. The firemen, they tried with fire. Oh, but couldn't melt that peanut butter sandwich. With ropes and pulleys, drills and coil, with steam and lubricating oil, for 20 years of tears and toil, they fought that awful peanut butter sandwich. And then all his royal subjects came. They hooked his jaws with grappling chains and pulled both ways with might and main against that stubborn peanut butter sandwich. Each man and woman, girl and boy, put down their plows and pots and toys and pulled until crack!
Oh, joy. They broke right through. Peanut butter sandwich. A puff of dust. A screech. A squeak. The king's jaws opened with a creak. And then, in voice so faint and weak, the first words that they heard him speak were, hobo, a peanut butter sandwich.